to the video. And let's not be in a hurry. My uncle, who was one of the most endearing people to ever walk on this planet, he would always say, make haste slowly. And certainly, we are not in any hurry right now. It takes tremendous will to not be in a hurry right now, not be rushed, even though we know that the problems are coming on strong, which is the new theme song I'm using, Coming On Strong by Brenda Lee, reminding us that suffering and sorrow and heartaches and tears are coming on strong in this world, and yet we must use our will to not be in a hurry, to make haste slowly. My dad, who was one of the more intuitive and brilliant people you'll ever meet, he told me before he passed on, he says, I don't want to stick around here for what is to come. Same thing my uncle said. He says, I don't want to. I know what's coming. I don't want to be here. So I tell you that those of us that are here are very courageous indeed. And we must continue to be courageous, because what is to come is overwhelming. Except to unconditional love. It's not overwhelming to unconditional love. And therein lies our refuge. We have a refuge. By turning our responses to unconditional love, we have a refuge. Cannot be overwhelmed by anything in existence, by any process, by any change. The unchanging is not overwhelmed by change. Keep that in mind. That which cannot be modified does not live in fear of modification. Truth does not live in fear of lies. Light does not live in fear of darkness. That which cannot be harmed does not live in fear of harm. That which is indestructible does not live in fear of destructivity. So we do have a refuge. And the refuge is with us right now. The kingdom of heaven is within. Unconditional love, seamless peace, seamless oneness is present right now. It's always present. And that is a refuge from all troubles that can ever arise in existence. We can literally be free of those. And yet, as we go through these next 6 months, the tendency will be to panic and to start rushing and making haste. I can already feel it, that there are some who are starting to panic a little bit and saying, my gosh, these videos, they're too slow, they're too long, you know, let's get to it right now. There's a vast importance in slowing down and not panicking, in maintaining composure, and making haste slowly, at spending time just simply in inquiry. It's tremendously important right now, so don't lose your nerve at this point or at any point to come. This last week has been like a nightmare that I'm just now awakening from. What a terrible time. In many, many, many ways, across the board, every level, great difficulty, shock. People are unnerved, even though I've told people, I say, make a great effort of will to remain calm during these times. It hasn't been easy. So if you've gotten a little disturbed, you know that's par for the course. But now it's time. I've managed to find a workaround around all the troubles, technical troubles that I've been having. I've lost about 20 videos recently because the erratic nature of YouTube webcam uploads and other technical difficulties, things breaking, no longer can I use them. But here we have a workaround. You know what? It's better than ever, isn't it? So we continue on now with maintaining our composure, knowing that we have a refuge. Beyond the question of whether there's a physical, external refuge for us, which I believe there should be and there will be, But even more importantly is the fact that we have a refuge within us that is ever present. The refuge of unconditional love, meaning love that attaches no conditions to you to respond to it. Everyone can respond to it. Everyone is welcome to respond to it. There's no hierarchy. There's no levels. There's no line to stand in. There's nothing you have to do to win this love. You don't have to win it in a lottery. You don't have to stand on your hands. You don't need to compose a great song. You don't need to bow to statues. You don't need to chant mantras. You don't need to do anything. You're already pre-qualified to respond to unconditional love on a continual basis. Everyone is. Everyone will always be that way. So that is the best news that can possibly be delivered. And it's great that we're able to share this information here on YouTube across the World Wide Web. That no matter what happens externally, this unconditional love remains untouched by it. And you have 100% access, as does everyone, in perpetuity. Both in the future and in the past, there's never been anything in existence that didn't have perfect access to unconditional love. And so if you look at all the troubles that have occurred, suffering and misery, it's simply because people decided not to respond to unconditional love. It's that simple. They decided they wanted to continue to pretend to be separate. Okay? But the fact is, cause and effect cannot be separated. And we're the effect of the Prime Creator. And we cannot create a separate reality. It's impossible. Keep that in mind. We cannot create a separate reality. We cannot create a kingdom of effects without a cause. We're trying to create a causeless kingdom. That is literally what we're trying to do. Cannot do it. So we're wasting our time. And we're getting frantic right now because we haven't succeeded. And here comes the sun. You know that song, Here Comes the Sun, by, I guess it's written by George Harrison or the Beatles, whatever. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun. Here comes the magnetic superwave from the center of the galaxy. It's about ready to arrive. And then the sun will do its dance. The miracle of Fatima in Portugal was all about that. The sun seeming to get bigger and bigger in the sky and come roaring towards the earth. Everybody was terrified as the sun seemed to strike the earth. That was a depiction of what is to come as the sun expands and heats up. So changes are coming on strong. We need to come on strong, not in a panic, not in a rushing here and there, not in a frantic effort to go somewhere in this earth. Where's the safe zones, you know? No, we need to be in a calm, quiet, peaceful inquiry. Not afraid, not panicked, because that unconditional love is already present, perfectly present, overlaying everything equally. Everything is already overlaid. Everything you see in front of you, behind you, around you, within you, without, it's already overlaid. This perfect unconditional love is already present right there, right now. And we just need to relax into it. Not a physical relaxation necessarily. It's a deeper release. Some spiritual traditions call it to surrender. The great surrender. Surrender living into being. Let unconditional love live your life as you surrender into the remembrance of being. Because truly what existence is, it's a mockery of being. It's an attempt to forget being. It's an attempt to forget what we are. Spirit is trying to forget itself. That is what we're trying to do. We are trying to forget what we are. Okay? Let me see if I can pull this up. There we go. Spirit is trying to forget itself. So what we need to do is remember us what we are. Remember ourselves. And unconditional love provides the remembrance of what we are. That is how we do it. So we don't need to be rushing around everywhere, because unconditional love is with us right now, right here where we are. Wherever any of us are at this moment, unconditional love is equally with us as it is everywhere else in the cosmos. So we don't need to go anywhere. We don't need to feel like we're under pressure. We got to get somewhere. We're under this tension to get somewhere right now, to flee. All we need to do is give up our desire to forget what we are and to realize unconditional love requires nothing of us, requires nothing of anyone. Somehow this has to sink in. We're not here denying that existence has changed and that sometimes the change is drastic. We're not denying that at all. We're not saying that external troubles can come. We're not saying there's nothing wrong externally. Externally, there's everything. Problems everywhere. What we're saying is that this is really has nothing, no effect on reality. So it's really nothing. Only what is real has meaning. What is unreal has no meaning. It's a temporary forgetfulness of what is real. And it has no actual real meaning whatsoever. So we don't need to be in a frantic rush to try and find some meaning. Unconditional love will remind us of meaning. It's meaningful because it doesn't change, because it's not trying to forget what it is. Okay, we are trying to forget what we are, okay? We're trying to forget what we are. Unconditional love is not trying to forget what it is. Unconditional love is not trying to forget what it is. It's not trying to forget its origin. It's not trying to forget anything. It's not trying to become something different than what it is. It's not trying to change or modify itself in any way. And so it conveys to us exactly that, of no attempt to modify or change. It simply is completely abiding in what it is without a shadow of discomfort or dissatisfaction. You see, and we can respond to that just as we respond like to a beautiful sunset, a beautiful place, something wonderful. As we respond to that, let's bring up something here. As we respond to the mountains and the beauty here in this planet. Okay, that's a response that's coming from our senses. We're seeing something, we're responding to what we're seeing. We can just as easily respond to unconditional love, but not by using the senses. The senses do not see it, do not register it, because it's unchanging, unmoving, everywhere. Senses are not designed to see that which is everywhere, which is unchanging, unmoving. It's even subtler than space, and not beyond subtle. It's not even subtle. It's everywhere. It's omnipresent. Completely pure, immaculate, clear, unwavering. Not the product of any process of energy. It's not an energy. And we don't have to run to catch it. We don't have to hunt it down. We don't have to search for it. We have to give up the search for it, because the search for it will never find it. As long as we're searching, we don't realize it's right here. with us right now. As long as we're trying to qualify for it, we don't realize that it's right here, right now. As long as we're trying to win it, we don't realize that it's ours already. As long as we're competing for it, we don't realize that everybody already has equal access. As long as we're trying to get a resume to present, get an identity to present, we don't realize that we're already pre-qualified. There's no requirements we need to meet. It's already safe. Unconditional love is safe, and it will give us the means to respond to it. And when we respond to that, we will feel like we're abiding in this peace, in this calm, in this total acceptance, complete forgiveness, non-judgment, not needing anything else, not needing to add or subtract anything. Steady, calm, peace, tranquility, bliss. And no matter what happens in this world, our response to unconditional love remains unruffled. No matter how hard the winds blow, the surface of our lake of tranquility remains undisturbed, even more so than the lotus flower here. You see little ripples here. We can be like this lotus, that even though in the waters of the world there are drops and there are ripples, and even waves and even tsunamis, the lotus remains unaffected. It remains absolutely still, absolutely tranquil. That lotus symbolizes our response to unconditional love that is already present, equal access to all. Everyone, no matter what, nobody can disqualify themselves from unconditional love. It's impossible. There is no way ever that the slightest disqualification or restriction can ever occur. Unconditional love does not judge at all. It is simply present as it is. That is its purpose. To be, have no desire whatsoever to change what it is. So if we could prevail upon it to say, you know what, we did something horrible and we should be disqualified, and unconditional love reacted to that and said, well, I better change what I am, because right now I am allowing equal access. I don't judge anyone because I'm not trying to diminish or change what I am at all. If unconditional love said, well, I'm going to make part of what I am different, then that would be changing what it is, right? Trying to change what it is. It would be ineffective at that point. So it's very important to point out unconditional love does not judge whatsoever. It overlays everything equally. Without any distinction. Therefore, it is exactly as it is. It's not trying to change what it is. It's completely complete acceptance and abidance in what it is, which is exactly what our identity is. Our identity is complete acceptance and abidance in what we are, and that is, we're the prime created. We're the effect of God, the prime creator. And the effect completes causation, okay? The effect completes causation. Cause without effects is not cause, is it? Because you can't, what can you point to say this is cause? Cause has to be cause of something. So the effects complete the circle of creation, cause and effect. One without the other means each is empty. And yet effects do not create cause, but they do complete it. Very important. Effects do not create cause, but they do complete it. What we are completes God the Prime Creator. We're spirit, and we complete God the Prime Creator. But we did not create God the Prime Creator. We did not create cause, but we complete it. It's a difference, very important difference. And what we're trying to do in existence is we're trying to be Prime Creator. We're trying to say, no, effects create cause. They don't, they complete cause, they complete creation, but they don't create it, cause. And this little sticking point is our arrogance and our pride, thinking that we can somehow be Prime Creators. Spirit's desire to be Prime Creator is the problem. It's the problem that we have right now. And the solution to this is to respond to unconditional love. And again, let's not be in any hurry right now. I'm feeling there's a lot of tension in the world right now. I don't know if you're noticing that. It's kind of like here we go. All pretense towards civility has been dropped in this world. It's now a dogfight. But if any one of us in this world is able to respond to unconditional love and not be in a hurry, be totally comfortable to be what one is, to relax into that, then that one acts as a great help to everyone else. We're very grateful that we have the opportunity here to present these videos in spite of whatever small technical glitches might occur. You know, those are very minor things. We can put up with all that. We can be like the lotus. Sure, the drops of water, problems are coming. Magnetic super wave is coming. It's been traveling towards us for a long time from the center of the galaxy. And it most certainly will have its play here. But it doesn't affect unconditional love. It has zero effect on it. At some point, we will realize this. We might be very close to this point right now. I feel that I am. But the shock of realizing, yeah, this magnetic wave really is coming, and problems really are going to happen here. That was a shock. We all want to kind of deny it, say, no, it's not going to happen, but most likely, it really is going to happen. Problems will come. They will come on strong. But unconditional love is untouched by this. It's our great strength. The Christians say, take refuge in Christ. The Buddhists say, take refuge in the Buddha. Each tradition says, take refuge in whatever symbol they use to symbolize unconditional love. The Hindus might say, take refuge in Samadhi or Nirvana. Different traditions use different terms for it. Vision of Christ, peace beyond understanding, vision of oneness. A Course in Miracles would say vision of oneness, vision of Christ. Others, teachers might say pure awareness, pure consciousness, pure bliss, or space, great space, or emptiness. Take refuge in that. And we literally need to do that. And there's a barrier of fear before that. And that is why we're inquiring now into unconditional love. We're inquiring into unconditional love to get past that barrier of fear. And I've created a new channel, which can be linked to Ascension Attitudes. And I have it on my channel page. I have favorite channels. It says Ascension Attitudes, Inquiry into Unconditional Love. And I welcome everyone to subscribe there, where we're going to go into great detail about unconditional love. And no, that is not a UFO. That is a reflection off of my watch. Calls to mind the time when there was this, over in Europe, there's this great release of white balloons. Thousands and thousands and thousands of them. And they all went up and they floated around in... They put on this incredible show in the air of like orbs. And people, well, I don't know, it was later on, next day or whatever. No, everybody had forgotten about it. And they were so high in there, and the sun was hitting them in such a way it looked like massive display of orbs. And everybody was very excited about this, saying the orbs are finally showing themselves, etc. I did an experiment. I got balloons. With helium balloons, and I let them go, and I had a very powerful video camera at the time with tremendous zoom. I was able to zoom up there and take video of the balloons as they were way high in the atmosphere, and they gave the exact same effect that these other balloons. So through researching this, I found out that it was not orbs. It was balloons, you see. So I am not some Kool-Aid drinker at all. All right, when I'm speaking about unconditional love, this is not drinking any Kool-Aid. This is there, it's a fact. When I'm speaking of problems with the sun again, it's not drinking the Kool-Aid. It's my very best efforts to discern what is to come. Nothing wrong with skepticism, as long as it's a healthy, open-minded skepticism that does the work and is not lazy, not expecting someone else to do all the work. So a lot of times there are phenomena like you see this dot there, and that's just a reflection of a watch crystal, actually. But perhaps in some grace of God way, maybe this happening here is cluing us into something, you know. I just noticed it, that somehow the sun was striking this watch in just a certain way, that it was producing this little orb-like feature here. So who's to say? Maybe someday the orbs will come. Orbs will come for us. The Bible says Jesus will return with all his angels and will bring us to where the place he has prepared for us. I think that's in, what is it, John 4 something. John 4:13 or whatever. You can Google it. Perhaps the orbs will return. Perhaps orbs will come. I have seen that in dreams of orbs coming, and we've been lifted up into the orbs, and beautiful, gorgeous, living light, unconditional love feeling orbs. Okay. Now, if that happens, you can trust that. What you should not trust is the mechanical ships, the saucers, the contrivances, who are run by the Greys, various ETs, who are working for the reptilians. They will take you someplace else that you don't want to go there. Okay, so if ships, metallic ships, don't get in those. Okay, yeah. There's no feeling of unconditional love there, is there? So there's another reason why to inquire into unconditional love. Should there be an evacuation on this planet, which I believe there will be, there may be quite a different few options we have. And we have to have discernment and say, is this option coming from unconditional love? Is it coming from Christ? Is it coming from unconditional love? Is it immaculate? Is it pure? Is it non-judgmental? Is it untouched by any judgment? Or does it know that we're pre-qualified? Does it extend this pre-qualified, unconditional welcome to us? And is it in no rush or hurry? Is it simply there, present for us? No coercion, no intimidation. And if we are in tune and in touch with unconditional love, we will then know yes or no, right? Be able to answer that question. Very important. Because certainly the evidence that I've accumulated is that there's a massive amount of transport devices in the solar system. And of different types. And we want those who want to go on the path of remembrance of what they are, they need to go to the right place. I don't believe that remaining on this planet is the best option, but that remains to be seen. That remains to be seen. That will be addressed as we go forward. But should this planet be evacuated prior to the sun going into red giant phase and superheating this planet, need to have discernment. Everyone needs to have discernment. And true discernment is to go towards that which provides remembrance of what we truly are, that which comes from unconditional love. So inquiry into unconditional love is a very practical thing. I'm a practical type in that we're not just going to raise troubles and fears in that. We want to say, what is the solution to it? What is the remedy? What is the actual remedy? What is the remedy for forgetting what we are? The remedy is remembering what we are. How do we do that? By experiencing that which is not trying to change what it is. And then we will feel comfortable with not trying to, the experience of not trying to change what is. And therefore we will give up the attempt to change what we are. Our arrogance to think we can be prime creator. We can change what we are. We can give that up. These are very practical. And if there's a problem with the sun, and I believe there will be, we have to have practical response to that. What is our response? Could very well be evacuate the planet. Where are we going to go? Well, we're going to go wherever that vehicle that's evacuating us is going to, right? That's where we're going to go. So we have to know, where is that vehicle coming from, right? They're going to be probably returning to where they came from. Where are they coming from in their attitudes? Are they coming from perfect clarity and awareness of unconditional love? Are they coming from mechanistic, process-based thinking and arrogance, based on change and instability and uncertainty and a belief that they need to win something, they need to evolve, they need to change, they need to grow, they need to find external happiness? All these attitudes, those are not ascension attitudes. So we'll say, no, we're not going to go with that. We're not going to go with that. We are going to go with that comes from unconditional love. Knowing that that will take us to a place whose purpose is to turn us in that direction, to remind us that this is our responsibility. And certainly teachings can be given there. I can give teachings, not a problem. I can give all sorts of clarifications, the whole gamut, through and through. I know there will be many teachers. There are many who are capable of this. Realizing that everyone has equal access. There are no dimensions or levels or hierarchies in reality at all. None. Everyone has equal access to unconditional love. Everyone has equal access to identity. Everyone is one. There's only the oneness in reality. There's only the oneness. There's no status. all, everything belongs to all equally, equal access. All ideas can be chosen at any moment by all aspects of spirit. Mind serves all aspects of spirit equally and perfectly. We're already immaculate. We're already pure. Everyone. We just need to drop the pretense of trying to be other than that. We need to get comfortable with this fact. We get comfortable by responding to that which is not trying to change what it is, by responding to the isness of unconditional love. And anything in the future, we have to insist upon what we're entitled to. We are entitled to live under God's rules only. We don't have to live under the ego's rules or laws, which is what we call nature, which is what we call existence. Existence is laws that we've made up. It's a fantasy. In dreams, there are laws, right? When you're in a dream, you're seeing the cars are on the street, electricity's working, everything seems to be functioning according to laws in the dream. And just so, we've made up laws, and everything in this existence is functioning according to those laws. We don't have to live under those laws. We're entitled to live under God's laws. We're entitled to only live under the authority of reality and the prime creator, and to function as we were created. We are entitled to function fully as we were created to function. That is our entitlement. So we must insist upon our entitlements. Otherwise, the ego will say that we're entitled to existence and say, this is your entitlement. You have to go with this. You have to grow. You have to evolve. You have to develop. That's the ego. We don't need to develop anything. We need to give up the incredible notion that we need to change in some way. We were created perfect to directly experience. Not to change what we are, not to grow, not to learn. We're not souls that started out as some ignorant, and gradually we go through consciousness and progress and gain more and more intelligence. That's the ego's hypothetical scenario of existence. We were created perfect and flawless with all knowledge, all clarity, all awareness, completely seamless. We're eternal, we're endless, we're invulnerable. And our genius is to simply experience directly the infinite rich tapestry of spontaneous experiencing that mind presents to us based on the ideas that we want to experience. And there's no death, there's no sickness, there's no vulnerability, there's no corruption, none of that. In reality, and we're entitled to that, and we're entitled to remember that, entirely entitled to remember that. And how do we remember that? By focusing on unconditional love. I don't know why this is flickering like that, but we can just let it flicker. We're in no hurry to change anything, are we? Let the bumps and the hiccups and the stumbles of existence, let them happen. Let's not be in a great hurry to fix anything here. I had to fix all the technical problems that I was experiencing here simply because it's my job to present this. It's a terrible burden, to tell you the truth. And my life has been immersed in struggling with technology just to try and present these videos of reassurance to everyone. But it's what I agreed to do. Okay, so it's not like I resent it, but it certainly is very frustrating and not easy at all. I spend my efforts, trying to fix the glitches and find ways to get around it, etc., and then doing the videos. It's working out pretty well, though, isn't it? Yeah. Very grateful for that. It's never easy. There's always bugs, you know. One day, the recording will work fine. The next day, it doesn't work at all. The webcam doesn't work. This work, that doesn't work. I mean, everything is buggy. It's all buggy. Technology has always been buggy, hasn't it? High tech. There's never been a day gone by when I didn't have troubles. Always buggy. And yet, during that time, I decided, you know what, let's focus on causation. Let's focus on what caused this universe in the first place. Why is everything so buggy, you know? Let's not forget the dreamer of the dream. Existence is an attempt for a dream to be free of the dreamer. A causeless existence. A causeless reality where there's only effects and no cause. We're literally trying to accomplish this, believe it or not. So is it any wonder that we've forgotten what we are? The whole purpose of existence is to forget what we are and to believe we're just effects. All these effects, the body, the world, the cosmos, all these effects, we believe that's it. That's all we're aware of. We pretend to be unaware of the dreamer of all this. But unconditional love will remind us of who the dreamer is, what the dreamer is, and the dreamer cannot be changed. That is correct. And at our task, at our responsibility, every month as we go towards the end of 2012, when it has been said that the sun will begin to be influenced by the super wave. Some call it a black super wave, gravity super wave, magnetic super wave. It's a super wave in the center of the galaxy of high intense energy, like a tsunami. It really is like a tsunami. The Japanese tsunami, Indonesian tsunami, was like a precursor, showing us that an earthquake, you know, causes these massive ripples. Ocean is a symbolic of space. So the center of the galaxy has this enormous upheaval, and it sends out this tremendous ripple through space. And when this ripple reaches land, planets, suns, matter, more dense matter, it causes a tremendous disturbance. And it can happen very quickly, almost without warning. Fortunately, we have the warnings here. I did foresee the Indonesian quake. It may have been a foreseeing of tsunamis in general. I spent 6 months of my life frantically trying to warn the world, and I got to tell you that nobody paid any attention. It was like at least a year in advance I saw the Indonesian quake. I said it would be, I even got the right 9.0 plus and everything that happened there. So it is possible to foresee what is coming. And there are space beings who are aware that this galactic super wave is coming towards us. And telling us that it's going to come on strong like a tsunami. So we have to abide in unconditional love. That is the challenge. That is the challenge of the times. That is the challenge of right now. That as these ripples come, we are the lotus. We are in the lotus of unconditional love. Let's enter into that timelessness, the timelessness of the unchanging. That is our responsibility. That is our ability to respond. It's very important to do it now and not continue to wait, not to continue to procrastinate. If we don't do it today, we redouble our efforts tomorrow. that is why these videos are being made available here, even though there's been a lot of obstacles. A lot of obstacles. But these videos are being presented here to remind us of what our responsibility is, our ability to respond, our ability to enter, to respond to unconditional love, to enter into the lotus of perfect peace, of invulnerability, to be the lotus. Not a mental trick, not a meditational trick, a choice, a choice. A simple choice. And we're struggling, we're working to get to that choice, and it is a struggle. We're worried, we're uncertain. We may shudder and tremble at sometimes thinking, oh, you know, wow, this is really bringing up a lot of fear. But you know what? We're doing it. We're succeeding. Because the most powerful fear of all is right now, is this fear of the coming galactic superwave and causing the sun to go crazy. I mean, that is how, what could be more fearful in an external sense than that? So just by outing this situation, by outing the fear, we're now able to start dealing with it. Okay? Not easy, but we're doing it. And I assure you that sometime from now, if we continue on with this, we'll find ourselves very stable, getting more and more stable and more assured that we will turn to responding to unconditional love. Our responses will be there. And we will know that what we are cannot be harmed even by the sun. Even if the sun turns into a red giant and fries the earth, what we are is completely untouched by that. Because remember, the nature, this dance of energy, is a fantasy of spirit and mind. Mind is a servant of spirit, and so mind is presenting this fantasy. It's a pretense, it's a pretending. It's a forgetting of what we are. It's a state of forgetfulness of what we are. This dance of energy. The dance of energy doesn't touch what we are. What we are is essence. There's no energy there. Energy doesn't touch what we are. So even though the sun can, you know, melt the planet down, it can't melt what we are at all. And if we abide in unconditional love, and we're, even if we're like an orb of unconditional love, that is unconditional love manifesting this orb, we will not be harmed by any of the energy of the sun. I actually experienced this, that I ascended up into the sky, into the light, which I am. I said, I am the light of the world. I am that light. I am the light of unconditional love. And everybody was screaming at me, saying, you're going to be fried. What are you doing? The sun is going to get you. And I said, no, it's not even touching me. And I was floating in the air, perfectly unharmed, untouched by this intense radiation of the sun. So I assure you that there will be a way to be perfectly untouched by the intensity of what is to come. We simply cannot panic or lose our nerve when we start to get all in a rush. This is what this channel is here for. These channels that I have up on YouTube is to give you this reassurance. All right, we've done a great job here. I'm just getting used to this new format. I have to, you know, do a lot of bells and whistles. It's fun. It's a challenge. And let's see if we can go back here to a little bit of theme music, which is always nice. I'm not sure where this theme music is at right now. Let me check in with it.
You can't help me down my pride and sin.
All right, that's a little choppy. The idea is that we tried to leave reality, okay? And that's brought us misery. Memories of a love gone wrong are coming on strong. This galactic superwave is the consequence of this trying to forget what we are and trying to separate from reality and create a causeless reality and claim that we're the prime creator as an effect, that effects are the prime creator now and not cause. And this is, and ever since we've been quote unquote gone from reality, in other words, in a state of forgetfulness of reality, we've been in a state of misery, suffering, teardrops. And in order to maintain this forgetfulness of what we are, we need to continuously go through these cycles of misery and suffering and change. And it doesn't matter what you call it, you know, it's that's what it is. It's how we maintain our forgetfulness of what we are. And we need to remind ourselves of this, that existence is suffering. I think that's the central tenet of Buddhism. Existence is suffering. Christianity says we're born into a state of sin, original sin. The same thing means existence is suffering. Unhappiness, sin. We cannot be happy with this dream of separation. We cannot. We can only be happy, find our happiness by remembering what we are. Okay? Very important. And what can I say about the technical glitches? Sometimes it works flawlessly, other times it doesn't. But you get the idea. You get the idea. All right. Very great. Coming on strong. And let your practice come on strong too. Let's see. All right. Very great. Here we go again with some theme music.